Welcome to this brief guide on how to create an org chart in PowerPoint. One of the things I get asked how to do a lot is creating an org chart. And this can be done in things like Visio, but it can also be done in PowerPoint, Excel, and Word using SmartArt. Here I've got my PowerPoint deck, and I've got my entire company here for the Excalibur Paper Company, starting with Arthur Pendragon and all of his direct reports, Kurt Wagner, Morgan Le Fay, and Max Eisenhart, and then their direct reports as well. As you can see, I've just simply marked these all using tabbed lists, but what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to use SmartArt to be able to create all of these in an org chart. So I select all of them using Control-C, I copy all the text, and then I click on my new slide, and I'm going to use the Insert tab in the ribbon, and then about partway along there, I'm going to select the option for SmartArt graphics. When I click on that, I get an option to select my different types of SmartArt graphics, and I'm going to choose Hierarchy, because that's what we need for an org chart. There are quite a lot of different options available to us here, but I'm just going to select the default organization chart option here, and select OK. Now it's inserted just a generic looking org chart. In this particular case, when I click in the org chart, I'm going to get the list of text boxes here where I can then start typing in the names that I would like. However, this is going to take quite a long time. It can be quite cumbersome. But what you'll notice is I have that list already. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select all of the text in this box, and then I'm going to use Control V to paste in my existing list. And there we go. We already have our org chart pretty much ready to go. However, it looks a bit bland, just in all green and white, so I'm going to adjust a few things here. What I'll do is I can use the SmartArt Design tab here, so I can quickly look through a few different options and effects that I can have. I'm just going to go with a little default one here, light colors and black text, make it a bit easier to read. And if I want to change the colors, I have a few different options available to me. I'm going to select one of the colorful ones so that it allows us to easily see that Arthur Pendragon is number one at Excalibur Paper Company. Now, if I wanted to make any other adjustments, I can use the Design tab, and I can actually use some of the presets or use the preset color options to adjust the colors that I have. So that way, if I would prefer to have, say, for instance, a purple sort of hue or just grayscale, I have the options available to me here. This can also pull from templated colors. So when you're using a work template, you can utilize our work color schemes as well. Now, when I click back onto the SmartArt Design tab, it'll give me back my options in the ribbon there, which we'll use in a moment. But should I want to adjust the positioning of any of these people, I can simply click in the text box, and then I can use the Shift Tab key to promote someone in the org chart, or Tab to demote them. I can also then use Shift plus Alt and then use the up and down arrows to move people up and down in this list if I have a preferred ordering system. As you can see here, I'm moving Eric down. I'll move Joachim down as well. This also works for the higher tiers as well. So for instance, for Max, I can use the Shift, Alt, and then up and down arrows to move them around. I can also use the options available to me here at the beginning of the ribbon to be able to do the same thing as these shortcut keys. And that is a quick guide on using PowerPoint and SmartArt to create an org chart. I hope you found this video useful, and I'll catch you in my next one. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel, and if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.